I feel like every, I don't know why I have this association in my head that when lightning happens, my internet goes out, but I don't know why I'm thinking that. You should be okay. Why are you so unhinged here?
Give me some content.
Destiny yells for entire 1.5 hour drive. hello, based alert.
I would have.
Why am I mad?
I can't drive.
Oh my God. Why is he so upset?
Just one ticket. Let me just try it. Nope. Let me just see.
Focus on driving. They're not for you.
I can't drive. Well, you're driving me crazy. Okay.
Good one.
Okay, Britney Spears.
I'm gonna fuck your mom.
All of these guys are trolling me the entire ride, by the way.
Just tell.
Tell me what?
What do the Arabs need for peace? And he's like, freedom.
Oh, I had an interview with Ahmed TB. What a horrible. No, I shouldn't say that. Oh my God, fuck. Oh, we gotta get back. These interviews are all so good. We'll get back there, okay? The storyline for this whole trip is so good too. We'll get back there. Oh my God, it's so much worse. We get to talk to somebody from, was it Haaretz? No, it was Bet Salem. We talked to a lady who works at Bet Salem, and then I talked to, in the Knesset, which is the Israeli parliament, there is an Arab-Palestinian elected official called Ahmed Tibi, Dr. Ahmed Tibi, and he is like the longest serving Arab-Palestinian in the Knesset. And my conversation with him was, it was just so wacky and wild. If I'm triggered on any particular drive, it's probably just because the managing this trip is incredibly stressful. It's like, it's just, because I'm juggling the calendar the entire time. I've got four different groups of people that are confirming me meetings and trying to juggle times with other people that we're meeting ahead of time. So I'm trying to balance all of that. I'm the only one in our group that can drive. So when we don't have security, I'm the one that has to do all the driving. And then people are obviously trying to cancel and move stuff around, and we're trying to like figure out like hotels and driving. For some reason, I got three tickets in one day. That's what she's doing right now. I think I'm asking her, can you figure out how to pay these tickets? I think I got three tickets in one day, okay, parked in Jerusalem in this stupid fucking van, all right? Ugh. But anyway. Why was the camera equipment considered a security risk for TB? It was just getting into the Knesset. There's a lot of security and shit. Did you not pay for parking or something? There was no way to pay for parking, okay? Oh my God, I will say though. I don't know if it's, it was a taxi driver, so probably an Arab, right? That's how it works over there. The people in this country are built different in some ways. So we're trying to find our hotel, all right? And I'm not sure if we need to take a taxi to a different place. Taxi driver notices us looking for a hotel, and he gets out of the car to help us find the hotel. Okay, and then we find it, thanks largely to him. He points us in the right direction. We're like, okay, thanks. I offer this guy a tip for his time, because I figure he's helping us, so he's not doing any fares, he's not driving. And he turns it down. I don't think in my entire life, not to knock the profession of taxi driver, I don't think I've ever in my life seen a taxi driver turn down money ever. I couldn't believe it. My God. Why do I hear so many people say I'm the only one that can drive when it comes to streamer groups? Why the fuck do so many streamers hang around people that can't drive? Well, Lena can drive, but I don't think she was comfortable driving in Tel Aviv or in Israel in general. The driving is a little bit wacky. Lonerbox can't, but he's Scottish, so they've got good public transport, plus he works from home. And then Yobel, I don't know why he can't. He lives in a place. I don't know how much I can say where he lives, but he doesn't need to drive. Can I just give you guys, I don't know how to impart this wisdom on you, okay? Um, whenever people say the drivers in some place are crazy, this is what this means like 90% of the time, I think, okay? Let me just help you out here, okay? When people say the drivers in X city are crazy, what they actually mean is the drivers are aggressive and are, yeah, their drivers are aggressive. Thank you, okay. However, in most of the places, actually wait, in every place that I've been where the drivers are crazy, they are very predictable. As long as you drive with confidence, you're fine in any of these places. So like, I had no problem driving in Tel Aviv, even though two of our security guys were like, oh my God, it's crazy. Like, they're terrible, they drive crazy. Not really, they just, basically when you're driving in a city, you've said this multiple times, yeah, I know, but I hear this so much. If you put your signal on and you start merging, they'll respect it, it'll happen, right? But it's not like a little town where you put your signal on and then you look behind them and then they wait and they clear out and they give you space and then they wave at you and then you wave back and you maybe like text them and say, hi, oh my God, I recognize you from the market. No, you just merge in, okay? Usually when people say the drivers are crazy, what happens is people will signal and they look and nobody's like making space for them. They're not going to make space for you. They're not supposed to. You just start merging. Okay. They're not going to crash into you. They're not even going to honk at you. They'll let you merge, but you have to merge. And Tel Aviv was the same way. Not only was Tel Aviv like that, I will say that somehow Tel Aviv was like, it was simultaneously, the driving is very aggressive as anywhere I've seen in the US or Canada, but also very like understanding. I don't know how to explain this. I don't know if it's like an evolutionary thing, but in the United States of America, if you live in a city, okay, if you are seven cars back and the guy taps his brakes seven cars forward, a gene will activate and you will honk your horn without even knowing somebody has stopped up there. And everybody in line will get the signal, okay? All of you are just driving and then everybody's honking the horn. It's like, I don't know what's going on, but I gotta honk because some guy like seven cars up like tapped his brakes. Everybody starts honking. In LA, New York, this happens in every major city. I don't know how it happens, but they do. In Tel Aviv, I got so nervous so many times at first because this I was not used to. We'd be driving and the security guy or whatever who's driving, he'll just like stop at the side of the road, blocking a lane of traffic, and then he'll hop out for like 30 seconds and do his shit and then come back in. Not a single person honks. Some people try to like go around and then other people sit and wait. And I'm like, they're simultaneously so aggressive, but like they're just, I don't know if they're just used to people just like stopping in the middle of the road. I'm like, the fuck? How is not a single fucking, the amount of honking in Tel Aviv is way fucking lower than I would have expected it to be. I'm like, the fuck? I don't know. I just thought that was, it was like very weird. It was very, very, very weird to me. I thought the constant honking was a meme from movies. Is it real? In U.S. cities, there's a lot of honking. Oh boy, dude, these motherfuckers like to honk. They do the same in Thailand. Nobody honks. It's a give and take. And also mentality of the people matters a lot. Okay. You're wrong. We don't do that shit in LA. If you blast your horn, people will hop out of their car on the freeway and shoot you. Where is this happening? What did I drive? On the Ventura Highway? Is that a song? That's a real thing, right? That I would hop into when driving from Glendale to LA? I don't know the names of all the fucking freeways, bro. There was also the Santa Monica. Is that the 405? The 5? I took all the major freeways there. People would honk sometimes. Yeah, for sure. I don't think I ever saw anybody shoot anybody. Yeah. Traffic just sucked in LA. Not to do the pity, whatever, like, oh, it was so much worse here. But if you live in LA for 1 year, traffic in no other place will ever bother you. And it'll be really hard to hold your tongue whenever people will say like, oh my God, like the traffic here is so bad. You're like, bro, I lived in LA for 2 months. You don't know what traffic is like, my friend, okay? Even New York City traffic can be kind of bad, but not LA bad. Because what you don't understand for New York is there's like times when the traffic is bad, and LA is just always bad, except for like from like 1 a.m. to like 4 a.m., okay? And then sometimes during the weekday, a little bit, like outside of like lunch break morning and dinner hours, it could be okay. DC traffic is worse than LA? Oh, I haven't driven in DC much. Public transit is way better in New York too. Yeah, I'm so sorry. I've repeated this like seven times too. I'm gonna keep harping on this, or I'm just incredibly lucky. Bro, riding on the New York subway, I legitimately just don't think that East Coast people know what homelessness and disease and people, I don't think they know what it looks like. I just don't think they do. Bro, I got some mithril chainmail. I had like a sword and shield. I went to the New York subway. I was like, all right, I'm going to ride this motherfucker. The last time I was out there, I was like, I'm going to do this. I'm going to ride the subway around because I want to know what it's like. Okay, I want to be doing, but I'm ready for it. And it's like, it's fine. I don't even know if there's a homeless guy there. I'm like, the fuck? It's like pretty clean. In and out of the subway. No crazy people. All the lights and the audio worked. I'm like, the fuck? I don't think people know what it's like being in Seattle, San Francisco, LA. The homeless problem there is just it's on another level. It's not even close. Unless New York City literally killed all the homeless people when I'm there. Or maybe they move them around like I'm Kim Jong-un and they're like, we got to make it look good for dictator Steven coming through. What part? To be fair, also, I spent almost all of my time in the city. I think I've been to Brooklyn once. and then I've gone to the Bronx once with my aunt when I was a kid. When I was like 20, I guess. But so maybe Manhattan is just clean. I'm pretty much always in the city. So maybe it's worse than other places. I'm not sure. The New York City winter purges the homeless. Yeah, maybe.
Loving on a beat, bro. Hype. Muster on a beat, ho. Bebo, penny rap, nickel, yeah, free throw. Man, damn, call out Amber Lambs. Tell him, breathe, bro. Nella nigga to the cross, he walk around like Tizo. What's up with these jabroni ass niggas trying to see Compton? The industry can hate me. Fuck them all in the mama.